The coronavirus is not only a public health or economic issue, but an environmental one as well, says our next guest. With us now for more from Laguna is Green Man Matias Gilberth, the environmentalist, professional speaker, and a consultant. Good to see you, Matias. Welcome to the program.
Hello, good morning. Nice to see you here as well, and greetings from lovely San Pablo City.
Indeed. So you're living out your fifth week of the ECQ in Laguna, just as we are doing the same here in Manila. What's it like, Ben, where you are?
The beard is growing. I haven't been shaving for a while, and I haven't been out of the house. It is obviously a tough situation for many people out there, but I'm enjoying the time with the family, not having to travel around for work or for talks, and it's quite relaxing here. And yesterday, for the first time, we got some support from the local barangay, but we passed that on to some more needy families immediately, the mini sack of rice with some sardines. So it's going okay here.
But you must have taken a peek out of your windows. You must be seeing more of the beautiful landscape around you there as the air pollution has cleared up amid the lockdown. Less cars on the road, less smoke and smog combined.
Definitely, definitely. It makes a big impact. Actually, I can see the black dust on our balcony. We have a lot of plants there. So it looks like a little forest there on our balcony. So that's where we spend a lot of time as a family. But we usually get dust after a couple of days of cleaning. And that is not the case. I have an indoor air quality monitoring tool that I use at home. And it's definitely reduced the overall levels of pollution. So this is a positive impact, if we can say so, the reduction of pollution and less carbon particles that might come from vehicles that don't have good emission control.
Yeah, just posting some of the incredible photos some of the residents are taking from their homes. This one's from Joher Adang, seeing the Sierra Madre Mountains from Pasig. Can you believe that? And Metro Manila skyline as far as Mariveles, Bataan. But Matias, this is only as good as it gets, as the ECQ's in place. So would there be any material impact to climate change?
I think it's just going to be a small reduction for a short period of time. But what is important is that we learn some of the practices and lessons that we are implementing at this point in time. How can we do teleworking in the future? How can we avoid all the traffic leading up to Manila? How can we enable our employees to spend more time at home? Flexi time as well. I think businesses can learn from this experience. As long as you have a good internet connection at home, and we have two connections here, this is one of the learning points. I think we need to radically relook at how we can reduce pollution in general. We need to shift to renewable energy, and the Philippines has got geothermal power as one of the base loads, the top three countries in the world. There's a lot of opportunities there. And we as individuals and companies can make the change. And when I first switched to renewables in the UK, I had to pay a premium. But here in the Philippines, contestable customers, they can do it without having to pay a premium for renewable energy. That is one of the steps we can take.
Taking this conversation globally, I mean, air pollution's declined in China following to the shutdown there because of COVID-19. Clearly, the drop in the level of nitrogen dioxide emissions have dropped significantly around the world, coinciding with COVID-19, which really drove people indoors. So how do you, as an environmental expert, reframe the narrative, pinning the COVID-19 pandemic to climate change to get the undivided attention of the world's leaders?
One important point is what is the source of all this crisis? And I think it's the exploitative economy that we have. The wildlife trading, which most likely was the source of the pandemic, and the way we treat animals is one of the problems we are having that increasingly leads to epidemics and impacts. Once we have the impact, as we see at this point in time, the impact striking us, it's too late already. We need to take preventative mitigation measures. once the impact of climate change will hit us in severe ways, and the Philippines as an island nation is one of the most exposed countries at risk from climate change. So we cannot wait till the impact hits us and then do some adjustments. We need to prevent the big impact, which would be the 2 degrees rise of temperature and sea level rises. And as well, it's a global problem. We cannot solve it alone as individuals. We cannot isolate ourselves. COVID-19, we see it's hitting the whole world. It's not just hitting the place where it started. So we need to look at this as a global effort to solve the problem. And particularly the Philippines has played a key role in some of the UNFCCC COP negotiations internationally, has played a very positive role. And I think I would like to see that role continue, because at the end of the day, the risk of climate change, the big long-term risk, is something we need to address here now for the sake of the population in the Philippines and the population of the planet. I have two young kids. One of them is 5 months old. One of them is 2 years old. They have a Filipino passport. I want to see them grow up healthy and sustainably in this country. So we need to focus on climate change and the UN Sustainable Development Goals as a joint effort for government, for individuals, and for businesses. And this is a moment of a wake up, of warning. Let's not wait till it hits us hard. Start the action now.
Well, now that you mentioned COP, I mean, COP26 was supposed to be hosted by the UK this November. Now, that's been postponed to next year. It's been 5 years since the landmark COP21 summit in Paris. So what's next with the committed timelines post-COVID-19 pandemic? COP26 was viewed as being especially important.
Yes, that is a good question. I think we will have to get some of these actions and timelines to be discussed through what we are doing now, online meetings and the internet. And we have to move away from doing everything face-to-face. That's the big learning point in the last couple of weeks, that people have realized we can do so much through online summits, online events. So I think we need to shift COP increasingly towards that process. We need to realize that there is even more urgency, even though the event itself has been delayed. I hope that politicians have taken the message. Now we see two trends. One trend is loosening of environmental legislation to give businesses an easier time, which is what we have seen in the US. But on the other hand, we have in Germany the expert group that was recommending the post-COVID opening up of the economy again, was making a strong point that we actually need to put a sustainable economy at the heart of the rejuvenation plan. We need to really focus on, like, what in Europe they call the Green Deal. That is the best way to get jobs and sustainable economy in line with the Paris Agreement targets. So we need a joint effort there at a national level, then supporting the COP process that hopefully will not be delayed but accelerated through online communication.
Well said. All about teleworking. That is a new normal, as we're doing right now. Matthias, thank you so much for joining
thank
us
so
and
much.
Enjoy the time with the kids. Keep well. Matthias Gelber, environmental expert in Laguna.